Ultra Human is debuting a new product called the Cyborg. It's a continuous glucose monitor that measures a proxy of your blood glucose level paired with an app. The app analyzes your glucose patterns and provides insights to improve your diet and exercise to optimize metabolic fitness. In this review, I'll share my experience using the Ultra Human Cyborg and really dig into the data to determine whether it can live up to the claims. Let's science it. Hey, welcome to Nourishville. I'm Dr. Lara. First, what is a continuous glucose monitor, and why would you want to use one? Continuous glucose monitors, or CGMs for short, are wearable devices that measure the glucose concentration in real time in your interstitial fluid, basically the watery fluid around your cells under your skin. It's a good proxy for your blood glucose concentration without actually having to access blood. CGMs were originally developed to help people with diabetes manage their blood glucose. Now, companies like Ultra Human are making them available to general consumers through off-label usage. Why use one? Research has been showing that blood glucose patterns, also called glycemic responses, are really important biomarkers for health. Lots of variability with super high spikes and steep dips, or blood glucose levels that stay high for a long time, are all associated with an increased risk of developing chronic diseases like type 2 diabetes and cardiovascular disease. Food and exercise, plus other factors like stress and sleep, all impact our glycemic patterns. But here's the thing. Studies have shown that there's a ton of variability between people and how they respond to food. So nutrition recommendations for me need to be different than you because our glycemic responses will be different. Ultra Human makes this data available to you so you can gain insight into your own glycemic responses, learn about what factors impact them, and tweak your lifestyle to optimize health. As a nutrition scientist, I'm really excited about the promise of direct-to-consumer CGMs for personalized health. In full transparency, Ultra Human provided me with the Cyborg for free so I could give it a spin. But this review represents my own honest opinions. Let's meet the Cyborg. There are two packages available, one CGM for $79 or two CGMs for $139. Each CGM lasts for 14 days. In this nice sleek package, you get some instruction manuals, equipment for inserting the CGM, these cool patches with little bumpers to protect the CGM, and the CGM itself. Their video tutorial made inserting the CGM a breeze. Once the sensor is inserted, it gets activated by linking to the app, takes about 1 hour to warm up, and then about 18 hours before the glucose level readings are calibrated. At least that's how the process is meant to work. I had a few hiccups getting started. Tech support messaging through the app was excellent. They responded promptly and walked me through how to get everything working step by step. After about 2 days of back and forth, I was up and running with the CGM. Using the Ultra Human Cyborg device is really simple. Most of the time, it's going to be updating its glucose levels live to you, the app, on your phone through Bluetooth. But if there are times that you get disconnected from your phone, you can scan the CGM device in order to get up to the last 8 hours of your glucose data using the NFC. So it's like this. So I would go here. Scan complete. Now, the ways that you tend to interact with the app throughout the day are to add your food and activity. So if I wanted to add this apple and pistachios and some coffee, what I would do is I would hit the little plus sign, I would add food, and I'm gonna search for foods, apple. I'm gonna call that a large apple. Add. I'm gonna add some pistachios. And it's gonna be 1 ounce of pistachios. And I'm gonna add coffee with milk. And from there, it's gonna give me a macronutrient split as well as once I enter that in, 2 hours or so later, it's going to give me a score for that meal or that combination of meal and activities in order to reflect the impact that combination had on my blood glucose levels. Let's walk through the app together to see what kind of data we get out of it. So the first number that you're gonna see up here is your current blood glucose level. And so that's gonna give you a value in milligrams per deciliter. It's also gonna give you an arrow to indicate whether your glucose level is staying stable, whether it's slightly decreasing, rapidly decreasing, slightly increasing, or rapidly increasing. Then this next panel here that we see are giving us an indication of our metabolic scores over the last few days. So the kind of yellowish color, I think, means like middle-ish okay metabolic scores. And then the days when we have these greens and blues, those are really excellent metabolic scores. They also give you an arrow to indicate whether your metabolic score was increased, higher, meaning good, or decreased compared to the day before. So we see that over the past few days, my metabolic scores have been only okay. I blame it on the Thanksgiving holiday, but that last Monday, it does look like I had a really healthy metabolic score. Then this panel down here is going to show you your glucose levels over the past several hours. So we see time along the x-axis and glucose level along the y-axis. The color of the curve is going to be indicating whether you are in zone or out of zone. So for this Ultrahuman CGM, they consider in zone to be anywhere up to around 105 or so, and then from and kind of this 110 to 115, 20 range is what they consider, like, you know, starting to get out of range. And then they consider your red zone, or the kind of avoid high glycemia zone, as being up 120 and above. So I have some thoughts on that, but we'll get to that later. Let's dig into this metabolic score. At the stroke of midnight, your metabolic score gets reset to a perfect 100, and it will change over the course of the day depending on your glucose patterns. There are three parameters that contribute to your metabolic score. Glucose variability, a reflection of the swings in the graph where more stable is better, average glucose, which is an average of your glucose level over the day, and time in range, which reflects the proportion of time your glucose levels are within the 70 to 110 green range. For me on this Monday, it looks like both my glucose variability and average glucose were quite good, but my time in target is pulling down my metabolic score a bit. And if we take a look at the glucose graph for the day, we do see that I was in the yellow zone after my dinner and that I had a big dip in the middle of the night. However, it's unlikely that it actually dipped that low. It's probably just due to the pressure on the CGM when I was sleeping on my side. Scrolling down, we can see data for all the individual events entered on my timeline. Sleep data was integrated through my Fitbit, and it provides the min, max, and average glucose level during my slumber. Then below that is my morning dog walk and oatmeal breakfast. Because these two events were so close together, they get a combined score. Let's tease that apart a bit. Physical activity gets its own fuel score. I got an underfueled score because my glucose level was below 80 for most of my walk, which I did before breakfast. Right after my walk, I ate my overnight oats, so these two events get combined together for a score that reflects my glucose patterns for approximately 2 hours around these events. My combined score was pretty good because even though my breakfast gave me a big dose of carbs, my glucose only rose 29 points because of the pre-meal dog walk. We can also look in more detail at my breakfast here. We see my glucose pattern for 2 hours after my meal. We see the ingredients that I entered and the macro split of my breakfast. Now, you may have noticed that I have two activity events at the same time here, the dog walk and the run. This is actually an artifact of how the Fitbit data is integrated into the app. The Ultrahuman app doesn't integrate directly with Fitbit, but rather through Google Fit. I have to use another app called Fit2Fit to get my Fitbit to talk to my Google Fit, and they only talk to each other once a day. So basically, there's a delay in getting my Fitbit data into the Ultrahuman app. I liked seeing my scores faster than that, so I would manually enter in my physical activity data. This may be an issue that is exclusive to Fitbit and wouldn't impact other types of fitness trackers. A really fantastic feature of the product are these real-time nudges. Since the app is receiving real-time glucose data through Bluetooth, it will alert you if your glucose is changing quickly and offer tips that you can act on immediately. I was warned of glucose crashes and recommended to have a snack, and also warned of spikes with a nudge to get moving. Most of the time, I was able to act on those nudges in time to prevent my glucose level from getting into the red zone. The app would also send feedback notifications based on patterns in your day. So I got some pats on the back for good glucose variability, as well as some warnings about nocturnal hypoglycemia. Though I think it was just that I was sleeping on my arm with the CGM. One note on the glucose level thresholds and metabolic scores. It's still pretty recent that CGMs have been used in people without diabetes, so researchers are just beginning to understand the day-to-day dynamics of glycemic patterns. Science is still figuring out what is normal and what is optimal. At first, I felt like some of the scores and thresholds were overly strict. Maybe I was just surprised at how often I ventured into the yellow and red zones. If you do try this out, don't get too caught up in feeling that you have to be perfect and always be in the green. Rather, approach it as a tool to learn your patterns and see how you can tweak factors to improve your scores. The most impactful thing I learned during my 14 days with the Ultrahuman Cyborg is that you don't need to do a full workout to attenuate those glucose spikes. I found a quick 15-minute dog walk or a 7-minute HIIT workout before or after meals really helped me flatten out my meal spikes. These are new habits I've incorporated into my routine based on the insights from the Ultrahuman Cyborg. I was highly engaged with the app for the full 2 weeks, and I felt like there were more experiments I wanted to run on myself once my CGM expired. Personally, I don't think I'd want to wear a CGM all the time, but I could certainly envision wearing one a few times a year. This would give the opportunity to compare it to previous data to see how lifestyle modifications have impacted your scores, plus it would be an opportunity for more self-experiments with food and exercise. Putting it all together, I really liked the Ultrahuman Cyborg. Their CGM and app combo is making glucose biomarker data accessible and actionable, both in the immediate through nudges, as well as in the long term, by giving me insight to tweak habits that are now sustainably part of my routine. It is a very data-rich app, and it does take a time investment to both track and reflect on your data. So if you want to try it out, make sure that you're ready to commit the time and brain space. I think that the cost of $79 for one CGM or $139 for two is very reasonable for the value, and a lower price than other competitors. The major pros of the Ultrahuman Cyborg are the real-time data streaming, which enables those time-sensitive nudges. This really makes our product stand out from competitors, which rely on scanning every 8 hours. I was also a fan of those bumpers on the bandages. I really put them to the test with lots of rolling on the floor in a dance class, and it thoroughly protected the CGM. The app is well designed and offers many layers of data to dig into. I love that because it gave me metrics to use in experiments, but I can also see how it could be overwhelming. As for the cons, there isn't anything that I would consider a deal breaker, but there were a few areas where I'd like to see some further development. First, in the food tracking function, I'd love to see a barcode scanner to make packaged food easier to add. I'd also like a feature to take a picture of food. This would be especially helpful when you don't have time to enter in all of the ingredients. If you've been CGM curious, I'd recommend trying out the Ultrahuman Cyborg. At the time of filming, there is currently a waitlist, but if you use my Nourishable link in the video description, you will be accelerated through. That's what science tastes like. Thanks for tuning in to Nourishable. Check out all my references in the video description and be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all things nutrition.